Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with criminal justice system. Now this is very very important topic. This topic will help you in general studies, mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Now in order to understand this criminal justice system, first of all we need to understand the meaning of criminal justice system. And apart from that, we also need to understand what are the lacunas in India's criminal justice system and what has been the recommendations of various committees, and in particular we need to understand the recommendations of Malimath committee on criminal justice system. Now when it comes to this criminal justice system, it deals with how much justice is done to the people who commit the crime, how much justice is done to the victim who bears the brunt of the alleged person who has committed some crime. So criminal justice system, it is a very important system in an independent state. The legitimacy of a state is basically dependent on how much justice it is able to give to the people, how much justice it is able to do to the people. Now basically in criminal justice system, two institutions are involved, two basic, two core and two fundamental institutions. The number one institution is the institution of police, and the second institution is the institution of judiciary. Now how police is involved in criminal justice system? When a crime is committed, it is the police which has to actually investigate the crime scene. So police is involved in investigating process. Investigation process, very very important. Once police has done the investigation of a particular crime, then it is involved in the process of preparing the charge sheet, And let me get in the more finer aspects of this. Whenever a crime is committed, after that police visits the crime scene, and after visiting the crime scene, police lodges an FIR, first information report. Once an FIR is lodged, then it is duty of the police to put forward that FIR, to send that FIR to the judicial magistrate. So the keyword here is judicial magistrate. Judicial magistrate ke paas FIR bhej di jati hai. And then it is the judicial magistrate which orders the proceedings of the case. And if the case is cognizable or non-cognizable, depending upon its nature, the arrest of the person is made immediately after lodging the FIR. Now, in some cases are bailable and some cases are non-bailable. Now, what is meant by a bailable case and what is meant by a non-bailable case? The non-bailable case means that you have to seek permission from the judicial magistrate. You have to seek bail from the judicial magistrate in the cases of non-bailable. In the cases of bailable offenses, a permission is granted by the police. And how a permission is granted by the police? Police generally grants the permission if you will put forward a grantier. It is the grantier which takes the responsibility of your bail. And after taking the guarantor's oath, police lets you go. And in this way, the bail is granted in the bailable offences. For the non-bailable offences, you have to knock at the door of the judiciary. After that, police begins to investigate the scene of crime in depth. This is also done in the preliminary phase. Once an FIR is lodged and in depth investigation is done before the passing, before preparation of the charge sheet. So once the charge sheet is prepared, it is always against the culprits which the police has found on the basis of investigation. And the charge sheet is filed against the people which, according to police, which police believes has committed the crime. And this charge sheet is put in front of the judiciary. That is the judiciary that will decide about whether a particular person named in the FIR, first information report, has committed a crime or not. Now it is the judiciary that basically decides. So this is how the justice is done to the victim. This is how the justice is done to a person who has committed the crime. Now if somebody who has committed a crime, in that case justice means punishment is given. Justice has been done. He has done something wrong. Justice has been done. He will be given a punishment. And this punishment to the alleged criminal will also act as justice against the victim. Victim will gain some kind of solace that somebody who has committed a crime has been persecuted by the court, has been punished. So this is how the criminal justice system basically works. Now we need to understand the lacunas in it. Now as far as the basic lacuna in the criminal justice system is concerned, it is in the form of the lethargy. The lethargic way in which the investigation is done by the police. Bahut hi bure dhang se investigation ki jati hai police se. Police, Indian police don't have access to state-of-the-art technology, forensic gadgets. Because if you want to investigate a crime scene, you must have access to the latest technology in the forensic science. You must have a distinct skill. You must have the knowledge, knowledge to preserve the scene of crime. You must have knowledge about the ballistics. You must have a very specialized knowledge in this domain of crime. But as far as Indian police is concerned, there are two branches, law and order branch and investigating branch. Now all these branches are amalgamated. They are co-joined in the case of police functioning. This is the biggest lacuna, because law and order and investigation, they in themselves are contradictory. They in themselves are incompatible. It is almost like somebody who is accounting is also conducting an audit on it. So both these functions should be bifurcated. This will be big reform in the criminal justice system, and this has been recommended by Supreme Court under the guidelines that it has issued in the Prakar Singh and others versus Union of India case. And this has also been the recommendation of the National Police Commission that was set up in 1970s. This is also the recommendation of the Marimat Committee. This is also the recommendation of the Soli Sarabji Committee. So various committees have recommended this bifurcation, this dichotomy. And then we need to specialize our police. Now another negative, the biggest lacuna is the judiciary. Now, when it comes to the number of the judges per lakh of the population, India has very less number of judges. We just have around 13 judges per 1 lakh of population. It is just that these 13 judges who have to deliver the justice. The judiciary is not quick. There is a famous saying like, justice hurried is justice buried, and justice delayed is justice denied. So in both the cases, justice is hampered, justice is killed, justice is injured. Agar aapko proper justice deliver karna hai, you need to provide it at a moderate pace. Moderate pace by letting both the parties put forward their concerns, put forward their demands. On the basis of the evidence, you can pass the verdict of justice. Now, when it comes to the criminal system, we have a penal code, that is IPC, Indian Penal Code. And this is very, very old, 1861. So we need to have a new penal code. We need to come out with a new penal code. And this has been suggested by Malimat Committee. Now, according to Malimat Committee, we should have four types of distinct penal codes for distinct type of crimes. We need to specifically differentiate between different kind of crimes. Because in the present system, we are treating crime, every type of crime, in a similar manner. Be that robbery, be that domestic dispute, be that economic dispute. Har tarah ke dispute ko hum uniform pattern se treat kar rahe hain. Har tarah ke dispute ka ek alag distinct code hona chahiye. Like economic offenses code should be different. Then we should have domestic offenses code. And then we should have social offenses code. And at last, we should have Indian Penal Code. So, like the domestic crimes, they should be dealt under a different criminal code. They should not be amalgamated with the issue of robbery, of killing, of murder. Because the nature of the crime is entirely different. This is how we can revive the criminal justice system. This is how we can address the issue of the criminal justice system. So basically, we need to restructure, we need to refurbish two institutions. One is police and the other is judiciary. And we must also keep in consideration the recommendations of the Malimat Committee. It is very, very important. Now on this topic, we get a question like, critically analyze India's criminal justice system. Then another type of question that you might get, it could be like, what important changes should be done to the India's criminal justice system in order to make it better? How can we address the issues of Indian criminal justice system? So these are the various type of questions that can be asked from this very topic. So this was all for the day. Now if you want to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. Or you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy IAS. You will find everything that we are doing on this very app. And if you want to read Brainy Map, you can all again visit the website. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.